Aloha, Sons and Waters. Aloha. We're just going to tap into the energies of what spirit wants you to focus on. Or any advice that needs to be heard, needs to be received. Always remembering and continuing to check in with self. Doing your breath work. Acknowledging the divine within and the divines that surrounds you. Queen of Swords. I feel like this speaks of getting your mind right. Thinking really logically about what it is you're doing. Not letting your emotions get the best of you. Let's read that from the book. The Queen of Swords is a fierce and exacting force. Turnadot does not forget betrayal, so her judgments, while fair and principled, seem brutal and cold. Still, she is open-minded and intelligent and can be charming and witty when she chooses. Speaks of protection, meaningful criticism, tough love, skepticism, and intelligence. So I feel it's focusing on being more open-minded, thinking really intelligently, continuing or being more charming and witty. Because someone may be holding on to something out of protection. Someone may be having to offer someone tough love out of protection. Maybe you're even having to give someone some sort of criticism. But meaningful criticism, not judgmental. This could be in regards to a connection. Speaking your truth, honoring your truth. But I feel like there's a lot of hurt that somebody may be holding on to that needs to be released. Feel like being more present, not focusing on what happened in the past, but moving forward. Three of Cups. This could be in regards to your friend group. People close to you. But I feel this energy is like getting out there, being more lighthearted. Somebody may be holding on to some sort of betrayal within their friend group, within people close to them. Somebody may have to cut someone off. Or maybe even communicate how this person makes you feel. I feel like clear, calm communication, though. Somebody may be, that may be a lesson of someone's. communicating. Not just cutting someone off. I feel like someone here may have lost a lot of friends. And they may be coming into connections where there's actually genuine people around them. The world. End of a huge life cycle. Somebody's definitely cutting off old friends, letting go of what happened within these friend groups, and they're starting to meet new people, getting back out there, traveling, doing new things, being more adventurous. So letting go of the past so you can wrap up this cycle already. Change. Changing up your friends, changing up the type of people that you hang with. I feel like more sacred connections, people that you can gather with and people that inspire you. Inspire you to be more healthy, to live in your purpose. People that are on the same vibration as you. Your vibration is changing. So your friend groups are going to change. The people you hang around with is going to change. The way you dress, the way you talk, the way you smell, the places you go to. Change. Nothing's permanent, is what I'm hearing. Somebody may have been holding on. Not really accepting the fact that things are changing. So maybe just staying stuck. Stuck on how things went down, just stuck. But things are meant to change. You are meant to change. You are meant to be around different people, new people within this new cycle. I feel like somebody's hurting because you cut them off. But they may be trying to cause drama or chaos, or maybe you cut them off because they were too much drama, too much chaos, a lot of gossiping within the friend groups, backstabbing, right? And that's the betrayal that she's holding on to. A lot of backstabbing happened and somebody's holding on to it and not releasing it. It's like, release it. Spirit was trying to remove those people from your life because maybe you wouldn't have, or something was being prolonged, and they want you around new things. Yeah, somebody may be, I'm just hearing it's just better to release it. Four of coins, three of wands. Someone's not willing to let go. Someone's not willing to open up, to get back out there. But but I do feel like you're able to escape. You're able to escape the things you wanted in the past with these people that were around you. It's changing. You're no longer wanting those things. So that requires you to be around new people. This could be new love as well. Dating somebody new. Somebody may be holding on to a connection that's dead. This is about letting go, releasing, being more present. Seven of coins. Because if not, you could run into a lot of delays, into a lot of feuds, I'm hearing as well. Things getting heated. And this could be, you know, you meeting new people and like there's still this back and forth things. Because I feel like if somebody's not focusing on wrapping up that cycle, forgiving, letting go, hold up, forgiving and letting go, it could manifest once again, wherever it is that you're headed. It's like you're headed towards freedom. You're headed towards new things. But it's like going to be a repeat of the old experiences unless somebody lets it go. It's like no matter where you're headed, if there's still things that somebody's holding on to, it's just going to continue to... Just going to continue. Same experiences with new people type energy. What can they do to release? What can they do to release? Seven of Cups and Eight of Swords. I want to read this from the book. Seven of Cups shows Aladdin standing before a myriad of fantastical dreams. It is impossible for him to pursue them all, and it's important he makes his decision wisely and quickly. It speaks of daydreaming, fantasies, decisions, wishful thinking. And then we have the Eight of Swords being represented by someone caught up in their own insecurities. Donkey skin was forced into hiding to escape a bad situation. Now she is faced with the decision to continue the life she has created or step out of her self-made prison. Speaks of anxiety, victimhood, feeling trapped, paralysis, and crisis. So the way you can move out of this is not by holding on to it. It's like when there's times I feel it's occupying your mind with things that inspire you, not focusing on the same thing. Somebody's feeling stuck. It's time to step out. It's a self-made prison. You know, if you've been hurt in the past, it's like not wanting to try it again because of what happened. But like I said, if it's being held onto that way so tightly, that's the very thing that will happen. So it's about releasing, all right? Once again. And somebody knows that, but they block it out. It's like they're betraying themselves. I'm just getting the betrayal because that would be Ten of Swords. Betraying themselves. Somebody's like backstabbing themselves by holding on to this. Like, I'm hearing spirit say, why are you mad? We were trying to help you. We were trying to help you move forward. And all of that old baggage couldn't come. Something's heavy. Something's heavy and it has to be more light. The only way it can become light is if you let go of that heavy load, that baggage. She's occupying her mind with beautiful things. And when you do that, you get on this vibration of really attracting what you want. Yeah, occupying the mind with what you want, happy memories. Because I feel like somebody may be like encountering some bullshit and they're like, damn, this is like deja vu. And it could be deja vu because it's something somebody's been holding on to. So focusing on letting go. There's that Queen of Cups energy. Getting out of the Queen of Swords energy. I mean, staying within that, but not being so brutal in holding on. I feel like they want you to shift into this Queen of Cups energy, being supportive with self. I feel like this tough love is also for self. Like somebody may be feeling that someone's watching you struggle or feeling like they could have did more, but it's like spirit may have been giving you tough love to build up your strength for your journey. Because I feel like you want to go places and you have to make sure you're strong enough, you know? Making sure you're able to support yourself during these times. Rather than just being closed off to self as well. Fantasizing about good things. Not fantasizing and daydreaming about bullshit. What's the outcome, spirit? Wheel of Fortune. You do it. You did it. I'm feeling the vibes of someone, like I'm seeing someone stuck on a web. They think they're stuck on a web. I'm stuck. But it's like, you're not stuck. You're the fucking spider. And in the best way ever, right? Somebody's feeling stuck on this web. But it's the web that you created. All right? And you get to step away from that web and build a new one. Web of deceit, web of lies, you know? And it's like now when you're weaving this new web, putting love into it. Intentions of peace and harmony and togetherness and being on the same page, the same vibration. And then we had the Four of Wands. Somebody's seeing the freedom. Somebody's about to feel really free when they let go. When they realize, I'm the spider, I'm the one that created this web. Or felt as if I was stuck, you know? And now that they realize who they are, they can move forward and step into new connections. Or even rekindling something, I'm hearing, for those of you that are, you know, in a sacred connection. Because somebody's realizing that they're not stuck, that they got themselves in this mess, they can get themselves out. Let's get a card from the angels and ancestors and close this off. All right. Oh, we got two. Ooh, green energy. Look at that. Green. Somebody's heart chakra is healing. Someone's heart is expanding. I feel like somebody could have felt like, I see an image of somebody's heart being squeezed. And the more they let go of this anger and resentment, fear, whatever it is, it's like somebody can breathe again. No more pain in the chest, no more hurt, because somebody's no longer focusing on it. They're shifting their focus, focusing on the growth. On the harvest, beautiful things coming in. Medicine guardian and the lady. So that's the medicine, right? And this is being open to healing, information, enjoy growth, and reap rewards. Being open to healing information. It's like being open, right? That meaningful criticism. You know, there could have... Yeah, meaningful criticism. I don't want to get too much into that shit. This is about being more healthy as well, right? I've been speaking about that a lot, eating more healthy, drinking healthier things. And that will also assist in bringing healthier thoughts, because you're taking that initial step to say, I want to put healthier things in my body. Especially when it comes to cutting people off and trying to surround ourselves with healthy people, healthier vibrations, then that means that we have to give ourselves tough love, you know, and say, I gotta cut that off. It ain't for me. It's not healthy. It's not beneficial. And I know that me staying stuck in an unhealthy energy, I'm not gonna be able to enjoy growth and reap rewards. But somebody's open to growth, open to the fact that nothing's permanent. I will read it briefly from the book. Medicine Guardian, page 108. That would be 9, the Hermit card. Well, I'm seeing 18, the moon, and then I'm seeing 9, the Hermit card. So it's like, I don't want to get into that. Okay. Listen to what is coming up within you and what is being shared with you by trustworthy others in your life. Pay attention to healing information. Healing angels can help heal you emotionally, spiritually, and physically with their energy, but they can also direct you towards information that will help you return to wholeness. When this card appears, information is being revealed that can help heal an aspect of your current situation, whether that be your health, relationships, or even career. So be alert for this. The medicine guardian has a healing wand, which represents the capacity to heal with the power of will and desire, and a chalice, which represents returning to a state of wholeness. So you have to be willing and you have to have a desire, right, to feel better. But somebody first has to acknowledge that they don't feel good, that they may be holding on to shit, right? All right. The medicine guard, okay. Okay, a state to wholeness, a state of wholeness, a state where your cup is no longer full, but overflowing with goodness. The emerald color of this card represents the healing rays of Archangel Raphael and his healing angels. You're being exposed to information and insights that will have a dramatic healing effect upon your life. If you're working through something mentally or emotionally, know that there are spiritual energies supporting your healing. If you're working through something that is physically challenging, pay particular attention to information that's coming to you that feels inspired, insightful, and warm. It will be supportive of your wellness. Your angels are here to remind you that your natural state is one of wholeness, and you're on the road to revealing that wholeness once more. Mm-hmm. Beautiful energy, y'all. All you gotta do is let go. Spirit's like, don't worry, I'll catch you. And why not let go if you're gonna be landing in a much better position than you are right now? Right? Being present, not to where you were before, but to where you are right now. Let's just remain present. All right. But somebody, I feel like not being hard on yourself for holding on the past as well, because I felt like, you know, that Queen of Swords energy, that was a form of protection. Because if somebody just cut off how they felt, they wouldn't realize, you know, I don't know. I got to move forward. Forward. Spirit's like, forward. Stop. 48. The Empress, the Hangman, and the Empress. I've been getting that energy a lot. Ooh, and I'm seeing 444. This time is wrong, though, on my TV. I think it's like 3 hours ahead. Oh, my God. And I'm seeing the female and male cardinal. If you've been here for a while, it's just been the male calling out for the female, and she returned, right? She's back. And then 444. 444 is 12 and 3. Motherfucker. 12 and 3. There's something about that energy. The Hanged Man. And the Empress. Yeah, right? The Hangman is stuck. But they're the only ones that can free them. Somebody may be waiting for somebody to free them. Free yourself. Be that Empress energy for the males. You know, that's that supportive, nurturer, creator. Yeah, that's interesting. I just said, that's fucking crazy. 12 and 3, and then, oh my God, you could be seeing 444 a lot. I'm tripping right now. Reap, so this is Lady. Reap what you have sown and enjoy the fruits of your labor. Grow and expand in all areas of your life. The Lady, I'm just kind of speeding it up now. Because once my phone hits like 30 minutes or something, it cuts off. That's why I've been doing part twos. Unless the video just cuts off. Anyway, whatever. Okay. The Lady, known as the Empress in the traditional tarot. That didn't even dawn on me, you guys. This is the Empress. This is Venus. I just spoke of the Empress. So this is Empress energy. So here. Listen. Grow and expands and all. I said that already. The Lady, known as the Empress in the traditional tarot, is a representation of the goddess in her most fertile form. She is abundant, bountiful, and a creative being. She is closely connected to nature because it's her child. She represents the maternal energy and has more than enough love to give to all who need nurturing. Yet she is a representation of the goddess Venus, too, and yearns for a rich relationship with her counterpart, the Lord. In this card, she holds an apple. Its seeds form a perfect pentagram, which in paganism represents the five elements of life. Fertility, growth, and abundance are all imminent when the Lady arrives in your life. All the seeds you have planted are coming to life, and there are plenty more rewards to come. In a material sense, this card can represent financial security, comfort, and it shows that there will be more than enough to go around. If you are making business deals or setting intentions to create financial growth, this card indicates a considerable amount of monetary success. The lady can also usher in other forms of abundance, opportunities, marriage, proposals, and even the birth of a child. She will help you respect nature and connect with its forces in order to have a genuinely supportive journey through life. Beautiful energy. Hit that like button. Cutting it short because it's gonna cut me off. Aloha.